Let's now try to learn a higher level braking maneuver. Until now, the base rule of braking was to finish braking before turning into a corner. However, if you remain on the brakes after you turn in, you can control the front and rear balance of your car, allowing you to counter understeer and so on. This technique is called trail braking. You still need to decelerate prior to a corner, but stay on the brakes slightly as you turn in. Turn into the corner while gradually releasing the brakes to control the front and rear balance of the car. We will practice trail braking. This will be a situation where you are prone to understeer, where trail braking comes in handy. This time, think about how long you need to stay on the brakes. When cornering, You want to start accelerating as soon as you are past the apex, so you need to finish braking by then. If you apply the brakes too long, you will not be able to reduce your lap times. Control your car so that you are finished with braking by the time you clip the apex. Next, you will be learning a line for a combined corner, where consecutive corners of different sizes are turning in the same direction. When you are trying to figure out the strategy for a combined corner, start by focusing on how to raise your exit speed out of the final corner. Thinking about the corners in reverse order from the exit to the entry should give you the right answer. The combined corner in this lesson is on an ascent in the first half and a descent in the latter half. Think about the line after climbing the hill. That will allow you to start accelerating as soon as possible at the last corner. Now, try driving down a section of the track that is on a descending hill. On a surface that is on a descent, the weight of the car normally on the rear wheels will be shifted to the front tyres. This will make the car more susceptible to oversteer. It is also easier to accelerate and harder to stop. On a descent, brake earlier than when driving on a level surface and complete your deceleration before entering the corner so that you do not oversteer. Also remember that regardless of whether you are going up or down, the spot at which the incline of the hill changes is a location where the car will be unstable. Now, try driving a section of the track on an ascending hill. On an ascending surface, the weight of the car normally on the front wheels will shift to the rear tyres. This will reduce the grip of the front tyres and make the car more susceptible to understeer. It will be more difficult to pick up speed and will be easier to stop. If you encounter understeering, it is important to ease off of the throttle in order to reduce speed. Also remember that regardless of whether you are going up or down, the spot at which the incline of the hill changes is a location where the car will be unstable. Now let's practice pitting in. Coming into the pit in order to refuel, change tyres, etc. is called pitting in. Here you will be driving in the final lap of a race where fuel consumption is tight. You are about to run out of fuel, so you will need to pit in and refuel before driving to the finish line. Once in the pit, select the replacement tyres and then the refuelling will take place. It is important to refuel only enough to allow you to complete the race. Be careful. If you misjudge the fuel needed and run out of gas, your car will be forced to drive at low speed. Practice refueling in consideration for the remaining number of laps. In the last three laps of the race, your rivals are also pitting in one after another to refuel. The positions will change rapidly because of this. You want to come out of the pit quickly to aim for the top. The trick to winning is to minimize your refueling to come out of the pit quickly. practice driving to save fuel. In the final lap of the race, you will be running out of fuel, but you don't have enough time to pit in if you are to win the race. Adjust the fuel consumption of your car using the fuel map of the MFD, multifunction display, and try to last until the end of the race. You can change the number of the fuel map with the directional buttons. Adjust so that your rivals won't catch up to you until you reach the finish line.